Hello, Sim here. So, the PS4, it's got a problem. It's a bit flaky when it comes to UPnP, which means you can't get an open NAT, regardless that you've got UPnP enabled on your router. You've powered off your PS4, you've powered off your modems and routers, and whatever you do, you still can't get an open NAT. It still gives you a moderate NAT. Now, originally I thought, it didn't occur until a system update had occurred. So I thought, I'll put it down to that. They'll fix it in the next one or whatever. Or was it Black Ops 3 and it hadn't been gaming for a little while? Well, no, it's definitely to do with the PS4. So I've managed to figure out how to get it to work. So I'm going to step you through what I did. So the nice simple one, first off, is close the application. So in this case, Black Ops 3. Go over to the settings menu and go to network and do test network connection. This does its look like network handshaking and opens up UPnP ports. Now, if you've got a router such as a NetDumo, you can look at your UPnP table and see whether it's opening ports. And if you're lucky enough, for open ports like 93808 and the magic port 3074, which is what COD traditionally uses. But if your PS4 is a bit ill, this won't work. So what I ended up having to do, well, it sort of works and it might not work. It was a bit flaky. So what I had to do was I had to go and do a good old PS4 recovery mode job. That means, you know, switch off your PS4 as per usual and then hold down the power button physically on the front of the PS4 for a good 7 to 10 seconds, and you'll hear one beep go off and then another beep a few seconds later and it shuts itself off. Now what you need to do is connect your PS4 controller to your PS4 via the USB cable, then switch it on via the controller. Here it'll come up saying, oh, please connect your controller. You press the power button on the controller again, and then you go to the rebuild database option and let it do its job. Now, on my particular case, I was still having a few problems after that. And I thought, I'll reboot the machine again. And I saw another rebuild database. So it's like, oh, okay, so you got a little bit of a problem. So it sorted itself out. Then I eventually got back to doing the traditional fix that had worked previously prior to me recording the video, when it decided, no, I'm not going to play ball sim, I'm not going to work. So you then go back to the settings network, do the test connection thingamajiggy again, and it still didn't work properly for me. Now, the final thing that I did, and this may be the trick, but I want to go through all the steps that I did so you guys can go through it if you need to, is that I then turned off the console again, but this time I physically removed power to the console for a good 10 seconds, even though it was shut down, to let anything else that had got itself in a bit of a pickle unpickled, then physically powered, you know, connected back to electricity, then switched on the PS4. Still didn't want to work, but then I went back to good old network settings test the internet connection, and I could see on my NetDumo that the UPnP port 9308 for the PS4 had opened up. So it's like, this is good, it's working again. Fired up the game and hey presto, port 3074 opened up and I got an open NAT. So I wanted to put this video out there to share with you guys. So if those of you who are experiencing these issues, and I know a few of you are, if this helps anybody out, it's always good. I always like to help people out as much as I can. Obviously, you know, I have a life. I can't be 24/7 tech support. But that was the method that I went through to get my games to become open again from an open NAT perspective. So the UPnP is buggy. You can Google it on the web and you'll see that the PS4 has got some flaky stuff. So to do a quick recap, if your PS4 is not that sick, close your game of interest, go to the network settings and do a test internet connection, and then relaunch your game and hey presto, all works. If it doesn't, use the recovery menu to rebuild your database, and maybe then after it's done that, reboot your PS4 again just to confirm there's no other things going on. Then actually shut down your PS4, full power off, and remove electricity so it's no physical power going to it. Then leave that for a good 10 seconds, switch it back on, then boot up the PS4 as per usual, go back over to the network settings, do the test internet connection, and then launch the game and you will get an open NAT. and I can confirm now that I am completely stable. The behavior is back where it was before, because the PS4 always, or certainly Black Ops 3, always wants port 3074, and it won't use 3075, 3076, or anything like that on a PS4. It should do, but it doesn't. So I confirmed that it's back to its good working behavior like it has been, because I fired up my Xbox to deliberately grab port 3074 and get itself confused on the PS4 when I launched it again, and did my standard clearing of UPnP tables and stuff on my router just to confirm it. Have I got a permanent fix? Is my PS4 back to normality, so to speak? And yes, it is. I've now got an open app permanently, so that's good news. So I wanted to share this video with you guys. So if you found this video useful, I appreciate a thumbs up. If you're new here and want to stay in touch with my latest videos, consider touching that avatar and hitting, subscribing to my channel. And until next time, this has been Sim.